Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I've been talking about direct lake mode in Fabric when you create a semantic model that's connected to a warehouse or a lakehouse. And one thing that I haven't talked about was a really important setting on your semantic models that you need to turn on or off depending on what you're trying to accomplish. And so whenever you're writing data to your lakehouse, let's say for example, and your semantic model is built on top of it, and because it's Parquet files, instead of overwriting the data inside of a Parquet file, Parquet files are append only, and so it just keeps adding based on the operation that you perform, and Power BI needs to be made aware of those changes. And so you need to reframe your model, and that reframing is done when you refresh your semantic model, okay? And reframing, it's a point in time way of tracking what data can be queried by the direct lake. And so whenever you have those inserts and updates and you do the reframe, it tells Power BI, hey, these are the Parquet files you should read. Whenever you create this semantic model, there's a property turned on that automatically streams that data. Depending on what you're trying to accomplish, you may need to turn it on or off. So you know how we like to do, instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I've created a lakehouse, it has a single table in it, and then I've built a semantic model on top of it. It's just a single table in this semantic model. And I have a report that I've created that I'll show you on top of this, okay? And so there's a property on this model that whenever you create your model, this property is automatically turned on. So if you go to settings, go to refresh, you'll see I have it turned off, but by default it's turned on. You can see it says keep your direct lake data up to date. So when you create your semantic model in direct lake mode, this property is always set to on. I'm gonna go ahead and click apply because I wanna show you what happens when it's on. What it means though is Power BI will automatically detect data changes in one lake. So to your direct lake tables, to the tables in your semantic model. So as you're adding, deleting, updating data, it'll automatically reflect that data when you issue DAX queries. If you're okay with that, keep that property on. So if you've built out your process and you're loading your lakehouse or your warehouse up and that data's streaming through, because the data can be transient and you want your report consumers to automatically get those changes, don't turn this property off. But if you want to orchestrate the refresh, the reframe of your semantic model as part of a bigger ETL process, a more enterprise ETL process, you should turn it off, okay? So right now it's on. So let me show you what'll happen. I'm gonna open up my report. So right now I have data for 6/9/2023 and there's 160 items ordered. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna double it. So for 6/9, I'm gonna double it. So I'm just multiplying my order quantity by 2. I'm gonna run this, boom. It ran, and so that property's turned on. If I go back to the report and refresh the report, it should be 320. And that's because I turned keep my direct lake data up to date. I turned that property on, and so as all these data manipulation changes are coming through, my reports are automatically gonna reflect those changes. So as people open these reports and refresh these reports, they're gonna see the data. Now, what if you go, well, Patrick, I don't want that to happen because I have things flowing in and report consumers could get inconsistent data and I wanna control it. Turn it off. So you go back to the model. Let's go back to the settings of my model under refresh. I'm gonna turn it off. Be sure to hit apply. And then I'm gonna go here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna delete everything from 6/9. So we click that, we run this, and then we go back to our report. You see it's still there. Let's refresh it, and it's still there. That's because I said, hey, don't keep my data up to date. I'm gonna orchestrate the reframing of my semantic model, okay? Two things happen as part of this reframe process. The first thing is all the data is kicked out of memory. And then it reframes. It says, okay, hey Power BI, at this point in time of my refresh, these are the Parquet files you need to read. Let me show you. I deleted the data, but I haven't ran a refresh operation. So you can run refresh using Management Studio. You can schedule the refresh, honestly, because everything's just kind of built in the fabric. It's like this one-stop SaaS solution for all my data needs. I'm gonna do everything inside of Fabric. So I'm gonna give you my two favorite options now. You can use SymPy inside of a notebook. So you can see right here, simple code, just import this module and then call fabric.refresh and then pass in the workspace name, the dataset name, semantic model name, and the refresh type. Before I do that, I'm gonna run this DMV. And what you're gonna see is that there's data in memory. And so one way to do the refresh is to just run this in a notebook. You could also use a new activity in the pipeline. I like this a lot. There's a new semantic model refresh activity. You just add it to the canvas, do some quick configurations, authenticate, choose your workspace, choose your semantic model, and then you can run this. Both of them will do the reframe for me. I'm gonna do this right here in my notebook. You can actually call this notebook from a pipeline also. So you got options here in Fabric to reframe your semantic model. So you can see I reframe my semantic model. I'm gonna run this. You've probably seen this DMV in my other direct link videos. And what you're gonna see is that nothing's in memory, because part of that reframe process is kick everything out of memory. The second thing is tell Power BI what to read. So now if I go back to my report and refresh my report, you'll see that 6.9 is gone, because now the reframe process is complete and Power BI knows exactly what Parquet files to read under the covers. All right, what do you think? I mean, I know it's a lot, but it will extremely help if you're building out an enterprise ETL solution to add this as the last step, whether you're using a notebook, whether you're using the activity and pipelines or whatever process you want to use. It's just so easy now because everything just built in. Yeah, any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric or Power BI or Data Factory, all the things inside of Fabric, there's probably a video flying where above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.